Hello, my name is Alex Disher and I'm from the NX Customer Success Product Marketing Team. And today we're going to discuss some new features and tricks using the NX Realize Shape tool that can quickly help users shape and develop models. To use these tools, we will be working on a gear shifter subdivision body similar to ones you might see in your own vehicle. By learning this process, you'll be able to create symmetrical designs faster and with more precision, saving valuable development time and ensuring consistent quality across your models. First, to access the Realize Shape application, you can go through the Applications tab to find it, or for this model, we can just select the subdivision body. With this open, we can see that half of the body is covered by nodes and edges, which is the Realize Shape cage. Whatever we manipulate on this half of the body will automatically be updated to the other side of the body, as well as eliminating the need for manual mirroring and reducing the risk of inconsistencies. To start off, we will use the Chamfer Cage command and work near the base of the gear shifter body. First, we can begin by selecting the three cage edges we want to chamfer. After having selected those, NX will create two new sets of nodes and edges at a distance we choose. We can either manually type this distance or drag the vector to our desired length. In this case, 5 millimeters. Moving on from the chamfer cage command, we will now use the transform cage command, which enables us to transform the shape and body of our cage. In the command window, we will first select our edges, as in this scenario, we only want to manipulate a node along an edge. Setting our falloff objects to the three new edges we created from the chamfer cage command will allow us to manipulate them. And finally, selecting the specific object we want to move, which is the very last node on the left. To move the node, we can simply just select and drag it to the desired location. We can then also use the falloff curve slider to move the falloff objects as well. Moving on again, we will use the chamfer cage command to select all these edges along the top side of the gear shift to create a new set of nodes and edges for us again to manipulate with the transform cage command to make grooves for better grip and buttons. This uses the same process as before, except this time, instead of using the edge method, we will use the normal method. After selecting all of our falloff object edges and each of the node planes as the movable objects, we then move it to the desired position we want for our model. In today's tips and tricks video, we've explored powerful tools with an NX Realize Shape that can help you streamline your design process. We've specifically focused on two key features, the Transform Cage and Transfer Edge tool. These tools demonstrated how NX advanced functionality can help you work more efficiently while maintaining precise control over your designs. Whether you're new to NX or an experienced user, incorporating these features into your workflow can help significantly enhance your productivity. Thank you.